Hey guys, it's your RS2 and to review the Bella Legoblade Star Wars Resistance Crew Transporter. So, this is the box here. So, you can see it's recommended for just 6 and up, and comes with 670 pieces and is set 10577. Comes with 5 minifigs, which are General Leia, not Princess Leia. And it comes with 2 Resistance Troopers and also Admiral Ackbar. So this is the top of the box here. So you can see it does have a carrying handle, which is definitely great. And shows you the actual size. And the side here shows you all the parts that the set comes with. This is how Bella does it. So yeah, the other side of the box here shows you what is at the front of the box. So this is the back of the box here. So you see, just shows you all the features, all the weapons that it comes with, and you know, all the kind of specs and technical readouts, I guess. But yeah, aside from that, that's it for the box. So this set does also come with a crate here, which is just a pretty normal one. So this is the instruction manual here, and yeah, it's pretty normal at the front. Doesn't come with any numbered bags, which is kind of unfortunate. But yeah, this is the final page, and this is the back, which just shows you the rest of the sets from the same wave. And yeah, it's definitely great that they made all these sets, because I don't think any other brand make them. Leapin makes a few of them, but not all of them. So yeah, it's definitely nice that Bella made them. But yeah, so that's it for the instructions. So these are all of the extra pieces here, and yeah, so you see there's actually not much here, but yeah, you just have 2 of these plates, and you got this stud with a hole in it. And yeah, these are all kind of like errors, because Bella doesn't include any extra pieces for their set. And yeah, but comes with this extra spring-loaded missile, and also this brick separator in black, which is definitely nice to get. But yeah, that's it for the extra pieces. So first off, for the figure, so this is General Leia, and yeah, so she's armed with this blaster pistol, and she has her unique hairpiece. Not sure if it's new or not, but yeah, it looks new to me. And yeah, so the torso print here, you got her jacket, and you got a pouch, and you have her belt. And yeah, her skin color kind of looks like purple in the video, but it's actually looks like the normal skin color, but it's just yeah, the paint is not enough. But yeah, so this is the back. You just have some linings, you know, and some design for her jacket or whatever. And yeah, so she has this kind of confident face, I guess, as her alternate expression. And yeah, but aside from that, that's it for General Leia. So the second figure here is this Resistance Trooper. So he's armed with this rifle blaster thingy, and yeah, so you have his Resistance Trooper helmet here, and you can pull this up. And yeah, the visor, I'm not sure if it's accurate or not, because I think the official Lego version of this helmet, this yellow visor fully covers up this entire top half of the head. And yeah, but So the torso printing here, you can see you got this scarf thing right here, you got the resistance symbol, you got two pouches, and this is the back printing, and I will show you the face, and this thing, Lego, they actually molded this piece into the helmet, and Bella didn't, so you have to attach this separately, but yeah, so you just have this normal, very common face. But aside from that, that's it for the Resistance Trooper. So this is the second Resistance Trooper here, and yeah, so he's also armed with the same blaster and in the same color, and yeah, so the helmet is the exact same, and I will remove this hip piece here, this helmet piece, and down there you can see you got Lex Luthor's face, and yeah, this type of resistance trooper, we already got this in the Resistance Trooper Battle Pack, and yeah, so you can see the torso, it's actually looks pretty great. So you have this bandolier here with some pouches and ammunition, and yeah, does also have his belt, and yeah, so this is the back, and you have all these straps and also the pouches, pretty similar to the front, but yeah, but aside from that, that's really it for the Resistance Trooper. Last but not least, this is Admiral Akbar. So he's armed with his blaster pistol, and he also comes with a mug in transparent, and yeah, it's definitely great. But yeah, so you see the headpiece is the very common Mon Calamari piece, and you have its eyes, and you have all these texturing. And yeah, it does look pretty cool. And yeah, so the torso, you can see you have this ranking thingy. Yeah, not sure, but yeah, he does also have his belt. And yeah, the leg printing, not sure what it is all about. Could be an error, I'm not sure. I haven't seen the official Lego figure before, but yeah, so this is the back. You just have some linings, and you just have the belt. But aside from that, that's it for Admiral Akbar. So this is the build itself here. So let's start with the cockpit. The cockpit here, it is a B-wing cockpit, and yeah, so you have this piece right here, which you can open up by, you know, turning this knob thing, and yeah, you can pull this out, and yeah, you got the interior. I'll show that later, but yeah, you have all these stickers right here, which you can see. Yeah, it's actually pretty hard to put on, so yeah, that's why it looks like this, because I'm very bad at sticker, and yeah, but so you have this docking hatch thing here, and yeah, all the decals here, they're all just stickers, and yeah, the stickers, they do look fine, but yeah, so this part is all the where all the life support systems go, and you know, the power generator go, and yeah, but you know, this knob is just right here. You can just spin it, and this thing will open up. But yeah, you also got this sticker, and you got this sticker, and you got this fin, and yeah. So the back, you got the crusters for this, and you know, you have the big one, and you have four smaller ones, and you have this really nice frame right here, and yeah, so inside the cockpit you can fit one figure, and yeah, so there's this printed piece, and you also have this sticker piece, and you can just put in a resistance trooper, and he just sits in there pretty nicely. And yeah, I'll just put him inside like that, but yeah, he's in there pretty securely, and yeah, so let's move on to this part, which is the I guess where all the gun, all the weapons go. But yeah, so this is the only weapon on the ship here. This is a heavy laser cannon, and you got all these like a targeting laser beam, and you have the bottom one, which is the supposed to be the shortest one. But yeah, this part is where the deflector shield generator go, and you got all these a lot of stuff inside, I mean in the real ship. But yeah, you just have a sticker right here, and you have this piece. Not sure what this supposed to be though, but yeah, these two, they are not weapons, they are deflector shield projectors. And yeah, they do kind of look like proton torpedoes or something. But yeah, you can see you do have the same fin as the cockpit part. And yeah, so the engines, it's also pretty much the same as the engines on the cockpit. And yeah, so moving on to the main part of the ship here. To start off, you have these spring-loaded missiles, which you can activate from the back, and you have their tails right there. And yeah, they do fire, which is definitely great. You just push down on them, and yeah, they do work pretty nicely for a bootleg toy. And yeah, and you have this extension part right here, which you have all these detail links, and yeah, it does look pretty cool. So the top, you have these stickers, and you have some design, and you can open this up. I'll show the interior later. But yeah, you have some designs right here, and you know, this is where the spring-loaded shooter goes. And yeah, you just have some other design. But yeah, so you have this ramp, which you can open up, and you just have this light right here, and two of these pieces to kind of block it, I guess, maybe, I'm not quite sure. But yeah, so the bottom, you have all these slider plates, and yeah, no landing gear or anything like that. But yeah, so one thing interesting here is that they do have this car piece, this front part of the car piece. And yeah, they used it on both sides to make this shape. And yeah, it's a pretty cool technique. So let's get inside. So this is the interior right here. So you can see the hatches, they do open up, and they are only connected by 8 studs. And yeah, they are pretty easy to take off. And yeah, but so the inside here, you can see you got two of these clips in orange, and you can clip their accessories on there. But I just wish that maybe they could have included a few more clips, but yeah, it's alright. So you have all these seats right here, which is, you know, which they just put these backrest pieces on there. And yeah, but you can sit more inside here, maybe, I'm not quite sure. But yeah, so here you can just sit on the resistance trooper. Yeah, here, this visor thing is kind of annoying, but you just sit him on there, and yeah, he sits inside pretty nicely. So this part, this kind of the command part, or the, you know, the control, where they, you know, give out orders and stuff. But yeah, this doesn't look quite accurate to the real ship though. But yeah, so you have these same printed pieces like the ones in the cockpit. And yeah, they are pretty common pieces though. But yeah, both sides, they are the same. And you can just sit in Admiral Akbar, and also General Leia in there. But yeah, they do fit in pretty nicely, but you just have to remove all of their accessories, like Admiral Akbar's glass or cup of water or something. But yeah, so once you are done, you can just close this up and you can just close the ramp and this ship can fly away. So yeah, but last thing here, the back, you have these kind of flap parts, not sure what they are supposed to be, but yeah, they are just there, I guess for the sake of detail. But aside from that, that's pretty much it for the Resistance troop transporter. So overall conclusion of this set here, so how do I think of it? The figures, I think both General Leia and Admiral Akbar, I think they are fine, but the Resistance troopers, like their helmets here, these bottom parts, chin guards or whatever, keep popping off, and yeah, I do kind of hate that, and I also hate that they didn't mold this yellow part into the helmet. And yeah, but the figures, they are pretty good. And yeah, so the build itself, I mean, it's fine, it's alright. The stickers, they are kind of a little bit greenish, which just makes them kind of the color, they are just kind of a bit off. So yeah, that's a little bit of a problem right there. But yeah, like, I mean, aside from that, I don't really have a problem with the build. I mean, quality wise, I mean, it's pretty good for a Lego Bullock set. And yeah, I mean, the spring-loaded shooters, they do work, so that's a plus. And yeah, I mean, the quality control of this for the bricks and all the pieces, I mean, they are pretty good. And yeah, so I mean, overall, I do recommend you getting this set, because yeah, this is the second choice for you to get this set in Lego Bullock form, actually, because Leapin has made this before. But yeah, the quality of the old Leapin sets back when they first started, the quality just sucks, and the figures, they just suck. And yeah, it's definitely great that Bella has made this and, you know, has given us a second brand choice. And yeah, it's definitely nice. So overall, I do recommend you getting this set. It's a pretty solid set. And yeah, so buyings for this set here down in the description box below, if I can find it, along with all my social media pages down in the description. So if you like my channel, make sure to subscribe right here and watch more videos right here. So that's it for the video. Thanks for watching, and I'll be see you very soon.